I can't wait to see Tommy C. He has a car for you and one for me. I can't wait to see Tommy C. He has a car for you and one for me. He can
ride. There is an organization called Wounded Warrior Project, of which I am the national spokesperson for. There's another organization called Wounded Warriors. Those are two different ones, so when you speak of this event, please call it by its correct name, the Wounded Warrior Project. Now, in case you don't know what they do and what they are about, the Wounded Warrior Project fights the fight after the fight. We see a lot of our brothers and sisters coming home from a battle, and we can see their wounds. But there are wounds much deeper than the ones we can see. I call it the enemy within. It's very discouraging to know that between 8 and 10 of our wounded warriors commit suicide monthly. That is a tremendous loss. That's what Wounded Warrior Project does. What they do is empower these veterans. I just came from New York and a parade, and Wounded Warrior flew 1,000 Wounded Warriors to walk in this parade. That's what they do. They put warriors together to talk about their problems, talk about their life. The Wounded Warrior Project does not provide prosthetics, arms, legs. They don't do that. They provide kinship. They provide an opportunity for them to talk to people in their same situations and get power and understand that they can survive and they can live in the civilian life without fear, without walking, without having to walk into a dark room and have the feeling that somebody's behind the door. We hear of all these things about they come home and they put all the pressures on the family because the families now become caregivers and they have to adjust. So Wounded Warrior Project also deals with the families because they have the same problem as the Wounded Warrior. They now become Wounded Warriors because they are now caregivers. That's a situation that they were not accustomed to and never thought that they would be in. And the greatest fear that a Wounded Warrior has is to be left alone, to be forgotten, to be stuck in a corner. These people have lives, they have hearts, they have souls. That's what we have to learn and understand. I think a Wounded Warrior Project chapter here in Las Vegas would go well. Based on what I see here, you need a chapter here. Chapters are needed around the country. And just to let you know that was not mentioned, but I am a 7-year Marine Corps veteran, Semper Fi. So I speak from the heart. I may be a celebrity, I may be a spokesperson, but I experience the Wounded Warriors, and it's from the heart.
To the objects below. When what to my wandering eyes should appear, in a miniature sleigh, an 8-tiny reindeer. With a little old driver, so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be sick. More rapid than eagles, his courses they came. And he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen. On Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen. To the top of the porch, to the top. they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop, the coursers they loop, with a sleigh full of toys, and say, Nickelodeon!
Oh, ho, oh, oh. Ho!
And then, in a twinkle, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little boy. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was all dressed in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had thrown on his back, and he looked like a peddler, just opening his back. And his eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples so merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. A stump of a pipe he held in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old lover, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, went straight to his work. He filled all the stockings and turned with a jerk. And laying his finger aside his nose, giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle. As he drove out of sight.